Hi there. In this YouTube podcast, I would like to share with you the workflow of Retopology when developing a 3D character with Scultpris and Maya. I don't know about you, but in my design practice, I always like to explore any given concept 2D drawings, and then I would block it up into 3D for finding the form of my design without worrying about the topology. To do this, I will only use Scultpris. Scultpris is a free digital sculpting tool that originally created by Thomas Patterson. It has great usability, and its seamless dynamic tessellation feature let me feel that as if I'm working with a chunk of a real clay. However, my reliance on a free-form digital sculpting workflow with Scultpris is a costly one, as it needs a lot of computing resource. I frequently hit a computing bottleneck and experiencing undesirable slackiness due to the limits of throughput from the computing hardware, especially if you are an indie game developer like me who can only afford a low-end laptop and a mouse to do some character work. I often find that my machine is not just slowing down dramatically when working on sculpting mesh, but it also heats up fast. And seriously, the hot air that blows out from the laptop air vent can really keep my coffee warm at all times. Thus, my workaround solution is to leverage on the Retopology workflow by reconstructing the sculpting mesh into an optimized polygon and then only dumping it back to Scultpris as a base mesh for further design exploration needs. To do so, first, I've exported the sculpting mesh out from Scultpris into an OBJ format before importing it into Maya. Then in Maya, select the sculpting mesh and make it into a live object. After that, open up the modeling toolkit and look up for the quad draw function. Okay, but beforehand, allow me to maximize my viewport by holding down the control spacebar shortcut key. Then, I'm going to reopen the modeling toolkit and activate the quad draw function again. By zooming close to the model, let's try to place a set of dots of 4 in this region. You can think that these dots are the anchoring points for vertices. Next, by holding down the shift key, or try moving your mouse over the blank space between these 4 dots. You shall see a shaded field of green. This preview is meant to inform you that if you apply the left mouse button click when holding down the shift key of your keyboard, a quad shall be drawn. Now let's repeat the steps again by placing more dots for drawing the quads that form an eye patch shape. If this is the first time you are practicing retopo workflow, I would advise you to keep it rough when plotting the dots with ample spacings. Need not to trace the sculpting mesh closely, as we can refine it later easily. You can also insert an edge loop into the quads that you have drawn by holding down the control key and combine it with the left mouse button click. But if you want to insert a center edge loop, then you should hold down the control key with the middle mouse button click instead of left mouse button. Then, invoke the paint relax function again to distribute the spacing of the quads afterwards. But as a matter of demo, I'm going to undo the insert edge loop steps, for in the practice of retopo workflow, avoid spamming edge loops at the beginning. We should only adding more divisions in a loop way after blocking out the base mesh completely. Next to share with you, it's pointless to try to align the dots that you have plotted with naked eyes during the tracing process. You'll never get a straight line in tangent, except that you need straight border edge for mirroring purpose. You can consider to turn the symmetry mode when doing quad draw. Alternately, you can reference what I do here by adding an edge loop first, then hit the keyboard shortcut key of Q for switching our quad draw mesh to the usual component mode. As a demo, allow me to isolate the view first. Then, double click to select these edges before you apply the scale function to straighten them. After that, you can pick these faces and delete them away. Next, exit from isolated view. With the reconstructed poly mesh in the selections, just turn on the quad draw tool again to continue your work. This demo is intended to show you that you can edit your quad draw mesh at any time while you are working at it. However, I would suggest you to straighten or set the border edges right when you are done tracing the entire mesh. The process of retopology will take you some time, but I find that it is worthwhile to plot the muscular flow of a head by hand for better meet the deformation needs. Okay, let me hit Ctrl Spacebar to return to the default UI layout of Maya. Whenever you are done reconstructing your mesh, remember to turn off the Make Live mode of your sculpting mesh, then hide the mesh away. In the channel box, you shall see there were lots of a constructing history behind this new mesh. I always have the habit of deleting the history away before duplicating it to assemble the head mesh as one. And if you would like to do an old-fashioned mirror duplication, you will need to set the pivot point right first before applying the duplication and flipping process as I have shown here. In the process of modeling, I can't stress enough that to keep your mesh in the quads even for game art. A good polygonal model will have a balanced distribution and spacing based on the level of details. Also, it can stand the test of a smooth preview. I will only triangulate my game mesh for final optimizations and loading purposes. As a demonstration, I have left some of the polygonal faces in three-sided tries, and let's see what will happen when we export a file to OBJ format and port it back to Scultpris. As you can see here, there is an error being thrown out by Scultpris whereby it doesn't accept a model that has too many tries. This also applies to model that has and gone. Remember, most sculpting tools don't work well with a model that has topological errors. Okay. Now, let's import a head mesh that is error-free in terms of its topology. As you can see, the new base mesh has only 4,500 overlap tries only. To continue to work on it, we can subdivide the base mesh 2 times for achieving the same high-res quality as the previous model with 20 times less of polygon count. This base mesh will be good to work at as it is light-weighted and won't eat up the computing resource. We shall have a lot of room to sculpt the details or extend our design explorations. And that's all for this demo. I hope that you find it is useful and adapted to meet your needs. Thank you.